Uganda Institute of Information and Technology's mandate is to provide high-quality market-driven skills, best training and research innovation that supports the development of a knowledgeable society. The Governing Council handover ceremony that has taken place today represents a significant milestone in UICT's journey. New board members of the 6th Governance Council, led by Dean Munene, have been sworn in today and promise to work in a very focused manner to ensure that more Ugandans get skilled in ICT as a way of dealing with the high unemployment levels in the country.
I, Dean Munene, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will not directly or indirectly communicate or reveal any matter to any person which shall be brought under my consideration or shall come to my knowledge in the discharge of my official duties, except as may be required for the discharge of my official duties, or as may be specifically permitted by the President. So help me God.
While officiating at this ceremony, the Minister of Information, ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Bariomusi, commended the outgoing leadership of UICT for the special role they have played in supporting government's socio-economic transformation journey through ICT. Bariomusi re-emphasized that the role of ICT remains strategically important in transformation of the country. He reiterated government's commitment to continue giving support to this sector.
Research, development, innovation, technology remain at the center of this transformation. So ICT is increasingly becoming very critical if we are to transform. And where we have reached, we cannot do away with technology. Because for us to move fast and move forward, we must integrate ICT in whatever we do. Even when you look at the other sectors, if they are going to improve, whether it is healthcare, whether it is education, whether it is agriculture, whether it is a trade, name it, where we are today, we must embrace and integrate the ICT in all this for last move.
Meanwhile, non-government organizations in Katabi Town Council, Wakiso District, under their umbrella body, Civil Society Organizations Network, have urged government to come up with a child online protection law that will be used to protect children from being exploited sexually, physically and emotionally through the digital environment. The Civil Society Organizations Network chairperson, Samuel Nsubuga, says a law to regulate and ensure cyber safety for children is long overdue.
A number of children have been exploited sexually or abused sexually, physically and emotionally based on digital environment. So I would urge the government to ensure that such children or all children are guided well when they are using internet.
Macnic Sickle Cell Foundation spokesperson Trevor Lutalo has advised parents, political leaders to take charge and monitor what their children are doing online, because there is an increase in moral decay, censorship and regulations should be put up so that they can be put to good use.
There needs to be censorship, there needs to be regulation of how children use these devices so that we can harness the exact importance of these devices. Now, when you look at the things that these children are exposed to that they shouldn't have been exposed to because there is no proper regulatory framework.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya and Godfrey Sempija for the news.